गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, क्लास 11 कॉमर्स, सब्जेक्ट बिजनेस स्टडीज, चैप्टर नंबर 1, इवोल्यूशन एंड फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ बिजनेस। इट इज लेक्चर नंबर 4। इन दिस लेक्चर फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम डिस्कसिंग अबाउट हिस्ट्री ऑफ ट्रेड एंड कॉमर्स इन इंडिया। ट्रेड एंड कॉमर्स दे हैव प्लेड अ वाइटल मीन्स इम्पॉर्टेंट ट्रेड एंड कॉमर्स हैव प्लेड अ वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल इन मेकिंग इंडिया टू इवॉल्व एज अ मेजर एक्टर इन द इकोनॉमिक वर्ल्ड इन एंशिएंट टाइम्स। मीन्स इन एंशिएंट टाइम्स ट्रेड एंड कॉमर्स दे हैड बीन वेरी मच इम्पॉर्टेंट। दे प्लेड अ वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल टू मेक इंडिया very much powerful in economic world in ancient times. Political economy and military security during ancient times. Again, there are two items, two things, two activities, political economy and military security during ancient times. They both came together in most of the Indian subcontinent. And trade regulations, the rules, regulations for trade, they were very much carefully planned. Political economy and military security during ancient times united most of the Indian subcontinent. And trade regulations were carefully planned. Indigenous banking system. And now listen, for the payment, which documents they were used? They are the two documents, hundi and chitti. Indigenous banking system, documents such as hundi and chitti, they were used for carrying out transactions in which money passed from hand to hand. Now see, what do you mean by hundi and chitti? Now see, hundi as an instrument of exchange, which was very prominent in subcontinent, involved a contract. Means these are the contracts, those could be involved. Warrant the payment of money, it means hundi and chitti, they were the warrant for money. The promise or order which is unconditional. You will do some promise or you will give some order, and that order was supposed to be unconditional. Unconditional means without any condition for the payment of money. Capable of change through transfer by valid negotiation. Valid negotiation, for valid negotiation, what was supposed to happen? Hundi. Documents such as hundi and chitti were used for carrying out transactions in which money passed from hand to hand through a valid negotiation. And the hundi was supposed to be unconditional. Unconditional means without any condition. Now, hundi as practiced by Indian merchant communities. Now see, Dhani Jog, name in hundi, it is Dhani Jog, name of hundi, Dhani Jog, broader classification, Darshani. Functions of Hindi. Now, functions of hundi. Now see, payable to any person, no liability over who received the payment. Darshani means, darshan माने हिंदी में बोलते हैं देखना. देखना माने जिसके पास वो हुंडी होगी, हमने उस हुंडी को उसके पास में देखा और पैसा दे दिया. And now listen, there is no liability over who received the money. क्योंकि वो हुंडी हमने देखी, वो जिसके भी पास थी उसको हमने पैसा दे दिया. एंड देयर विल बी नो लायबिलिटी ओवर हु रिसीव्ड मनी. सहज योग दर्शनी, ब्रॉडर क्लासिफिकेशन दर्शनी। फंक्शंस ऑफ हुंडी, नाउ व्हाट विल द फंक्शन ऑफ दिस हुंडी? पेबल टू अ स्पेसिफिक पर्सन, समवन रिस्पेक्टेबल, लायबिलिटी ओवर हु रिसीव द पेमेंट। नाउ लिसन, नाउ द मनी विल वॉज सपोज टू बी गिवन टू सम स्पेसिफिक पर्सन, इट कुड बी सम रिस्पेक्टेबल पर्सन, एंड देयर वॉज द लायबिलिटी ऑफ द पर्सन हु विल पे द मनी एंड हु विल रिसीव द मनी। सी, लायबिलिटी ओवर हु रिसीव द मनी, इट मीन्स जब पैसा हम देंगे तो ये देखना है कि कौन किसको हम पैसा दे रहे हैं, एंड आई एम लाइबल फॉर द पेमेंट। फरमन जोग दर्शनी, हुंडी मेड पेबल टू ऑर्डर, इट मीन्स टू होम ऑर्डर विल बी गिवन, वी विल पे द मनी। देखन हर दर्शनी हुंडी, पेबल टू द प्रेजेंटर और बियरर ऑफ द हुंडी, जिसके पास भी हुंडी होगी, जो भी हुंडी दिखाएगा उसको पैसा मी विल बी पेड। धानी जोग माने मुद्दती, पेबल टू एनी पर्सन, नो लायबिलिटी अगेन हु रिसीव द मनी, बट पेमेंट ओवर अ फिक्स्ड टर्म, इट मीन्स आफ्टर सम फिक्स्ड टाइम द अमाउंट वॉज सपोज्ड टू बी गिवन। आफ्टर दैट फरमन जोग मुद्दती, हुंडी मेड पेमेंट टू ऑर्डर फॉलोइंग अ फिक्स्ड टर्म। अगेन लिसन, हुंडी मेड पेबल टू द ऑर्डर फॉलोइंग अ फिक्स्ड टर्म, मीन्स यू हैड टू फॉलो सम फिक्स्ड टर्म एंड देन द पेमेंट वॉज टू बी डन। हुंडी मेड पेबल टू ऑर्डर मीन्स अकॉर्डिंग टू ऑर्डर द अमाउंट वॉज सपोज्ड टू बी पेड। देन जोखमी मुद्दती, हिंदी ब्रॉडर टर्म, ब्रॉडर क्लासिफिकेशन इज मुद्दती। फंक्शंस ऑफ हुंडी, ड्रॉन अगेन डिस्पैच्ड गुड्स, इफ द गुड्स लॉस्ट इन ट्रांजिट द ड्रॉअर और होल्डर बियर्स द कॉस्ट एंड द ड्रॉई कैरीज नो लायबिलिटी। अगेन लिसन बेटे, ड्रॉन अगेंस्ट डिस्पैच्ड गुड्स, If goods lost in transit, the drawer or the holder bears the cost, and the drawee carries no liability. Drawee की कोई liability इसमें नहीं थी। Now move on to next topic, that is rise of intermediaries. Intermediaries, they are the middlemen. Now see. Intermediaries played a prominent means very important role in the promotion of trade. Means the middlemen, the intermediaries, they were very important if you want that your trade should be promoted. It comprised commission agents, brokers and distributors both for wholesale and retail goods. Whatever the business you wanted to do, it could be wholesale business, it could be retail business. Commission agents were there. Commission agents were playing the role of intermediary. Then transport. Transport by land and transport by water, they were very popular in ancient times. Trade was maintained by both land and sea. Roads as a means of communication had assumed key importance. They were very much important, so roads as a means of communication. And now see. हेयर कम्युनिकेशन मीन्स सामान को लाना, लेके जाना, सामान को लाना भी और सामान को लेकर के जाना भी, इट इज कम्युनिकेशन। देयर आर सम स्पेसिफिक वर्ड्स विच आर इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय सीबीएसई बोर्ड, सो डू नॉट बी कंफ्यूज्ड बाय द वर्ड दिस कम्युनिकेशन। रोड्स एज अ मीन्स ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन हैड अज्यूम्ड की इम्पॉर्टेंस इन द एंटायर प्रोसेस ऑफ ग्रोथ। means if the condition of roads was good only, then we could think about the growth. But in that ancient time, see what was happening. Roads, they were very much important, and they had assumed very much importance so that the entire progress could take place. Now move on to trading communities. In different parts of the country, different communities dominating trade. Again, listen. In different parts of the country, different communities dominated trade. There are few examples which are listed below. Punjabis and Multani. See, they were handling business in northern region, but managed the trade in Gujarat and Rajasthan. And Mahajan, they were handling the business of Western India. Chhat traders, they were handling the business of South. Now move on to merchant corporations. The merchant community also derived power and prestige from guilds, which were autonomous corporations formed to protect the interest of traders. Again, listen. After some time, there took place merchant corporations. They were brought into existence so that the interest of the traders should be protected. If the traders were protected only, then the growth was supposed to happen. See, the merchant community also derived power and prestige from guilds, which were autonomous corporations formed to protect the interest of traders, which taxed trade and industry tax, custom duties, ferry tax you all know. If you want to do the business by waterways, then you have to pay some amount. That amount was in the name of tax, ferry tax, custom duties, you know. Trade and industry tax, that was supposed to be paid. Major trade centers. Now it is very interesting. It is all I am discussing about the ancient India. Ancient times when there were only two ways. Ways were roadways and seaways or waterways, you can say. First number, Pataliputr. It was only commercial town. And what they used to do? It was export of stones. Second number, Peshawar. Exporting for wool and importing of horses. Third number, it is Takshila. And Takshila was a city of financial and commercial banks. Fourth number, Indraprastha. Commercial junction on the royal route. Fifth number, Mathura. And Mathura was emporium for trade. Sixth number, major center of textile industry, gold silk cloth. If you have ever heard about Zari, the Zari work was done in Varanasi. Seventh, Mithila. Established trading colonies in South China, especially in Yunnan. Means in Mithila, there were trading colonies. In South China, especially in Yunnan. Eighth number, Ujjain. In Ujjain, see, they used to do export of muslin. It is the name of cloth, agate, mellow cloth to different centers. And listen to your homework. See, you have to write and you have to learn today's topic, whatever is covered today. Thank you so much.